It's something most of us with dogs do every day. Go for a walk.
You wish you could just, like, turn back time and not have gone. Like, he would have still been here.
But this walk through her North Fort Myers neighborhood ended with that woman in the hospital and her dog dying in her arms.
It was attacking me to get to my dog, and no one could stop it.
Now neighbors are left worrying it could happen again to their dogs or children.
I've had calls all morning this morning because people are afraid to walk. We've got kids here. We've got grandkids here.
As you heard, neighbors worry that dog that went on a vicious attack will escape its yard again and kill another dog or worse, hurt a child. Thank you for counting on NBC2. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. The woman who was attacked just got out of the hospital. Only NBC2 Samantha Serban is talking with her tonight about the traumatizing ordeal. Samantha joins us live in North Fort Myers.
Peter, Kelly, it was just this time last night when Lindsay Norton and her Pomeranian Ever were turning the corner onto Harborview Drive. Now, that's when a dog named Taco escaped through a back fence and Lindsay's life changed forever.
You wish you could just, like, turn back time and not have gone. Like, he would have still been here.
Recounting the worst night of her life, Lindsay Norton can't help but cry.
It really does feel like losing a family member.
Norton and her 9-pound Pomeranian, Ever, were just across the street from this house when a dog allegedly escaped through an open fence and attacked.
I was able to get him, like, in my arms again. But it was, like, as soon as I caught him, this dog ripped him out again.
There were four of us on that dog. I was kicking it. He was beating it with a shovel. She's wrestling. This dog and yelling, get it, let go of my dog, let go of my dog, let go of my dog. It was horrible.
Norton was able to break her dog free, vehemently trying to get away when the dog named Taco attacked again.
The meanness in that dog, that's just unheard of. I've just never seen that. That dog was, I don't know, possessed or something.
Obviously, he was biting him in his midsection, where all of his organs are, but also shaking him really violently.
When Taco's owner got the dog into a chokehold, Norton tried rushing Ever to the vet.
I was just trying to pet him and hold him as close as possible.
But it was too late.
I could feel the tips of his ears getting cold. And his toes.
The 3-year-old died. Domestic Animal Services did not take Taco, who is currently quarantined at home. That brings a whole new concern to the neighborhood.
It's nerve-wracking now to even walk down the road with our kids.
Now, Norton wants you to hear her story in hopes that something like this won't happen again.
I'm not like a anti-pitbull person, but this was not a dog. This was a killer, and it was not going to stop until it killed the prey that it saw as my dog, and it's just not fair.
Lindsay told me the dog's name, Ever, came because she was looking for something unique, and she thought it was similar to Forever, which she hoped Ever would be her forever dog.
Oh, your heart just breaks for her, Sam. Did the other dog owner have anything to say about the attack, and do they know how the dog escaped?
So we talked to Taco's owner very briefly today. He did not want to go on camera with us, but said the dog escaped because a lawn care worker accidentally left the gate open. Now, when we talked to people in this neighborhood, they say they didn't even know that there were dogs living at that home. I'm local in North Fort Myers. Samantha Serban, NBC2.